necessarily be staying in that mid lane. As soon as he gets that package, we'll be delivering it to Marge and Megan, perhaps. Duke in top laners. SOFM can also get involved. Again, another big player for the lineup. He was definitely looking towards those lanes, was getting the team rolling, as Fruskieron was mentioning. But now he's on Lee Sin, a champion who can really pop off. We've seen that from Ben Four earlier. Can really just be that champion who can do everything by himself. But regardless, Raz, we are now on to the Rift 4. Game 2 here with Snake and IG. We'll see who can take Game 2.
When I look at IG's composition, and I mentioned how, you know, it's set up to get Rookie going in the early on portions of this game, but they have a lot of control. They have a lot of control in their composition, and Ashe and Zyra, Trundle as well, if he looks to play through these team fights. So just looking at it, it feels good if they can get the game going in their favor. But with the mobility with Corki, and of course I've talked about the bottom lane potential here, it is a bit of a worry, but I can see this going to team fights. Hey.
Hello there. How's it going?
I look fantastic. I like the producer out there giving me that reminder.
giving us some love.
Give me a different angle.
It was good we weren't standing up, actually. Oh, you know. Out really well.
Yeah. I mean, I have nothing to hide.
I hope that hope that worked out. See if we can get a good gif out of that one. Megan and Marge. War of attrition in the bottom lane. Trench warfare. Throwing skill shots back and forth.
Meanwhile, they're just... You got Duke. Kid. Looking to give him the pounce. Saying, hey, you know what? We know you're coming out. Waiting for that blue buff.
We'll find you. Right on cue. Here comes the buffs. And yeah, back into this bottom lane. Megan trying to clear out that ward. Not going to happen. And ambushed in the jungle, in their homes. Kid comes in here.
What did they do to deserve
stealing that? Stealing his belongings, stealing away that blue buff. Honestly, dark times when you think about it for the jungle camps.
Yeah, they don't even have friends anymore. They just stripped them from away from them in the last patch.
Yeah.
Goddamn preseason.
Ruined it for the jungle camps. However, lots of those friends have gone down to the Krugs, most annoying camp in the game, and of course the chicken camp in just off to the mid lane. We're into this mid lane. Talking about that one, Rookie and Tank trading blows, and that got that level 2 advantage. Tank still trying to fight Rookie, even with that level 2 advantage.
Rookie took more damage from the
minions. From the minions, yeah. I was watching back away. I was like, actually, this trade not so bad.
That wasn't a fantastic trade, but Rookie better understand that he's not an auto-attacking champion. That's Corki. So yep. You get your abilities out. You back away. The minions are looking at you.
Yeah. Tank's got friends.
Yeah.
Oh, SOFM. Taking away this Grump here. Kid is on his way to that jungle. Ready and waiting. He'll ambush this crab before he even knows what's happening.
Oh.
Out of the darkness.
I do know that ward is catching him off. So Kid's just not having a good time. Oh, with that being said, SOFM gets caught out here.
He's rapidly approaching Megan and Marge. Lands the Q onto the Ashe as well. Really nice timing on the exhaust, blocking so much of that execution damage from SOFM.
Oh.
Kid, he's rolling in. Oh, the double knock-up onto Minton. SOFM might be enough though. Kid's dropping low. Oh, it's going to be Jungler's exchange. Marge returning fire onto Mo. This is a bit of a back and forth, but Megan under attack. He'll flash away. Marge now needs to get out of this one. We'll have to burn his flash. Oh, the summoners. All the summoners burned down from IG.
The only summoner that is up and available.
Yeah, sure, SOFM has a few, so maybe you can blame him for dying out in that situation. But take a look at this. He weaves in there, gets Marge, he's able to back away, and he said, you know, I got exactly what I need. You know, Marge, you don't have your heal. And they had a ward in that in the river as well, so they got Kid coming through. But they knew that they can take this fight. They did. At the cost of SOFM, he could flash away because he knew that Mo and Mint had the kill. He didn't have to stick around. So he actually did. It was an avoidable death. But regardless, you'll get 2 flashes on Marge and Megan. Mo still has flash, so you know what? That's a win.
Yep.
I'll give it a win. It's a win for Snake there.
And that was also a triple knockup. I didn't even see in that last fight.
Yeah.
However, I don't feel like there were that many kills, were there?
I feel definitely wasn't.
Did more people die while that replay was happening?
There are 2 deaths in the bottom lane.
We need to CSI the crime scene here, Raz.
All right, something happened.
Yeah. Well, I'm looking towards mid lane. SOFM just walking up, hit the young S key there. Just show Rookie what's up, and then back away and take away the farm.
Wait a minute. I don't know. We'll find out.
Yeah, I'm pretty confused right now.
All right. This is interesting. This is
maybe we'll get a replay of that replay.
This is gonna kill me.
Okay. Oh, here we go. All right. Okay.
Okay. Something happened.
I knew something was up.
Oh.
Do I team fight this one? All right. Boom. In with the flash. Marge gonna go down. Oh, look at the damage. And Megan Run away! You can make it! Run, Forrest! Mint, look at the damage from the minions, though. This is probably where it happens! Oh!
All right. For the win. Oh, well, good catch, by the way, with the kills. I was like, you caught me off guard. I was like, wait a minute, I'm pretty sure nothing. I guess, actually.
Yeah.
You know what? There was only one fight happening this game.
Yeah.
All right, well, great. You know what? Replay, thank you for that. That was great. Thank you.
However, I did take that one and play-by-played it, so now we need another replay for you.
We do.
To analyze it.
That's fair.
But we can talk about what that means, though, because that was two kills traded back and forth. And the lone summon, the only summon that was remaining from Moha, has been burnt. So no summoners in that bottom lane. So likely the junglers will be back down there because it's a pretty easy lane to gank. But it's going to be Rocket who's under attack. SOFM, no ultimate from him, but tank not to damage. Oh! The Q goes off to the side. To be fair, he didn't have the vision of him.
That's the thing with levitating champions. I'm going to put this out there. Levitating champions, like, oh, you got him now. But Syndra and Kayle, really difficult to hit with Lee Sin Qs. I'm going to put that out there.
Yep. Do I hit the feet? Do I hit the head? Where do I go with
Where
it?
Do you go?
It's oh, I aimed at the wrong place.
It's kind of like Aurelion Sol. You have to hit the head or you're hitting absolutely nothing.
Yeah, the tail doesn't mean anything on Aurelion Sol. Lots of people don't know that, but everything will go through that one.
Yeah, so that's a bit of a fun one. The exhaust came through. Corki didn't have much mana for that one, so it was all up to Lee Sin on that one. He misses it. So it was still a good look overall. You want him to keep making those, getting that action. But in the bottom lane, you did ask me about who won out in that situation. I would say that Snake won out because that's a double kill on Varus. Overall, I mean, Zyra got the last kill. You know, Zyra does a bit of damage, just not at this point in the game.
We'll accelerate Megan a little bit towards that point, but for sure, getting Mint and his item breakpoint earlier on into the game is a big deal. So 300 gold in the bank will help him out with that. And Kid, he's in a battle to the death with the Crab. He did emerge victorious. And he'll head back to his jungle.
That's the thing with pacifists. They never win at the end of the day. I mean, sure, yeah. You win through morals. You didn't want to pick the fight with Kid.
But did you actually win?
Mm.
No. No, you did not. There is no winning.
Yeah.
SOFM. Your red buff, not a pacifist, but he's still not winning. He has won against many a player, though. Great many players have perished to the red buff. And in the bottom lane, now the push up from Megan and Marge, a lane that we weren't... didn't have a lot of high hopes for in terms of doing well in this lane, but they got the show.
Yeah, and it's Megan's putting down a lot of hurt. Another big point, too, is looking even in the top lane. That being said, Kid is kind of watching this out. Might even look for a dive.
Da-da. Here comes Kid. He spots him over the wall. Won't be a prey seeker just to follow him after. Knows it won't be enough damage to finish him off, so.
Even had Rookie kind of pivot in that situation, so that was 100%. Sure, you lose, you get a blue buff, but that's a lot of damage coming out of this tower. I might even just be, they might even just head out Rek'Sai to commit to it, but no, they'll just back away.
Tank, interesting recall in the middle of the lane, as Rookie has ultimate, but SOFM was there just in case. So, he's fine. And Kid is also there, so it's all good, it's all good.
Yeah, in the top lane right now, Trundle, sure, he only has that 5 CS advantage, but overall, he's working quite well. He's got his Tiamat, he's back, I guess I was wondering if he would go all out for the Hydra. And just continue that split push. I think it's a pretty good matchup for him. The only thing that makes it harder for him is SOFM. Get out of there. But what makes it harder for them is the fact that Maokai actually can deal with those trades well with the Courage of the Colossus and extra shield in his kit. So it's not that bad. 10 CS is pretty bad. I should stop looking at it because we don't know how big that wave is top, and you just randomly got 5 CS.
Yeah, I mean, we haven't seen the top lane at all. I actually forgot there was a Maokai and Trundle in this game, to be fair. So, yeah, we'll see how that minion wave resolves, of course. And it's all about the bottom lane, all about that mid lane, where all the action has been happening, the junglers getting involved. And as we were just mentioning them, they have turned up in the bottom side. Tank, he has the package.
Oh.
And the Void Rush. So this is the setup from both teams. And Tank will fly back to the mid lane. And it seems these two teams, well, I'm going to hold that forward for a second. This tank will find Rocky in the mid lane. Lots of damage coming in. He has to be careful. He does have the Hex Drink, but Rocky has
take
the
fight.
Ultimate. He will be followed after on Niche Power. Rocky, for a little bit more Dark Sphere, not going to be enough to finish off his opposing mid laner. And after all that, no kills go down.
That's what Hex Drinker gives you for the first round. Huh? That's not thing is going to come with that one.
It's just like Ace in the Hole, right? It's just a bit of extra damage you can just get down there onto your opposing ADC.
I suppose so. SOFM, of course, realizes that, and he's probably going to look for something. He's not going to have tank this time around to actually help him through.
So this should not be a dive. It's actually going to be incredibly hard for them to dive this IG bottom line here.
All summoners, Stranglethorn's available.
Yep.
Exhaust. Full health. Yep. Gonna say quite hard to dive. SOFM.
Marge may not have ulti, but I don't think that matters.
I think so. There's Chains of Corruption onto Marge. Lots of damage just alone from those two bot laners. SOFM is honestly getting bodied by that one blast of the rush from Megan. So it'll back away. And that was the end of that chapter.
Yeah, that was hard. I mean, that was a lot of poke damage. The best I could really come up with that situation. But there's no way any of them are going to look for that fight, especially since SOFM has only damage, has no tankiness to his name. None of them want to actually tank that tower for that long, especially since they're full HP.
Hello, Mint. He's underneath the Stranglethorn, so we'll have to flash away from that as he was hit by the Grasping Roots. So he'll have to burn that summoner. May open up an opportunity for Kid, who wants to make his way down there. And yeah. Indeed, he is in that river.
That's pretty crucial. We remember last time that tower was chunked down quite a bit. Sure, Ash used her ulti, but that's a pretty low cooldown. It's already coming up in about 10 seconds. So right now, they're going to back. They don't have that much mana, but they have that timer involved, and they know what they're working for. So Kid's already getting pressure around here in the river.
Yeah, he was warded out, though. It was a really nice timing from Moat, noting his AD carry didn't have the flash again with their tower low. Place the ward, see Kid on his way, so he'll have to take a more inventive route to the bottom lane if he wants this to happen. And that may be what he's looking for. Marge has his ultimate, lands onto Mint. Remember, no flash, but does have that heal. Still, Kid will get the knock-up, and I think Mo honestly just kind of have to leave his ADC out to dry there. Nothing he can do about it. And a nice kill to Kid.
Yeah, I don't know why the exhaust came down at that point. That was the easiest play. You should have recognized that was going to happen the moment Ash comes back into lane. And the moment you get caught out by, just save your sum. Especially since Dragon is still up. It's an Infernal Dragon. Why would... It was a bad decision overall. It looks like it's just going to mean worse things here. Oh!
Tank in the mid lane, up against Rocky. He's out of mana. He's hitting with auto attacks. Nothing really happened.
He tries. He makes the attempt, man. Yeah. I respect that.
A plus for effort. Mm-hmm. D minus for anything else. Kid and Marge take the bot tower. SOFM.
Oh!
Oh! Knocked back into the tower. Follows up with the Q. Great knockback. Let's get to the Wii and blows them up with unleashed power. Well played to Rocky. Really the champion that IG need.
Oh, you hear that sound? That's every jungler in the world tilting off the face of the earth. That's Syndra right now. Syndra damage. Doesn't matter how fancy that play is. And let's take a look at how fancy it was. Oh. Does that matter? Here we go.
You think that was crisp?
Pushed away and then ulted. So, you know what? Absolute skill coming from Rookie here.
Oh, really well played. That was honestly a treat to watch in the mid lane.
That was a pretty good timing on his shove, though. That was actually, I'm going to respect that. I don't even know if the damage came through on Lee Sin Q on the last bit of it. It's actually because another ability did fly at him at the same time. So maybe he did avoid the extra damage. In the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. He has a lot of HP, so he probably wouldn't have died to that regardless.
You know, Raz, either way, it looked sick.
It looked sick.
That's what we need to know. As commentators, we just need to get hyped about it. And that was cool. Mm-hmm. Good job, Rocky. But in all seriousness, Rocky was the player that was holding IG in the game pretty much in the last game. So getting him some kills, getting him into this game is something that will be in IG's best interest. SOFM. We'll think twice about going back into mid lane, I have to feel. Or maybe look towards top lane or bot lane. Still have not even seen top lane. I'm pretty sure the camera has not gone up there.
It actually hasn't. We'll have to take... Maybe they don't exist anymore.
Maybe it's a 4v4. We have no idea.
I mean, we're looking at it with the summoner. I mean, look. The funniest thing is we are actually looking at it in the minimap. Maybe the minimap's lying to us. Maybe it's trying to trick us into believing that there are actual characters in the top lane.
It's a definite possibility.
We need proof.
We do. We just need to go up there, guys. I know the observers can't hear us, and definitely probably won't speak English either. But
I mean, to be fair, it's really just Duke. He hasn't gotten much of a CS advantage. It's legitimately just even 140 to 140, and on top of that, he hasn't gone back in so long. He's actually just been sitting on the components for his Hydra for a very long time. He has no intent of looking to split push. Whoa!
Megan with a full follow-up and really good follow-up on that arrow. Mo so low. Flash away plus the heal. Keeps him alive. Duke in from the top lane. Hey, he does exist. Here comes the pillar chasing after the subjugate as well. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, Tank, the big one, not enough to finish off Rocky. Oh, but it is enough to finish off Megan. And he'll go down. Meanwhile, the great chase continues. Mo, he's quite fast though. So he may get away, Kid. That Frey Seeker.
He's gonna get him
with the Tram Sense. Again, still would not be enough damage. That's not an AP Rek'Sai.
But just take a look at that before the replay even comes through. I mean, this is a really tough situation for Marge. Marge is actually just walking up?
Gotta be careful with Tank. He might finish him off with some rockets.
What was he trying to do?
I don't know, but he survived.
All right, well, just taking a look at Rookie for that team fight, that was actually really well played. And I just once it does come through, all we're going to be doing is just focusing on Rookie because he actually should have died a million times. It's so frustrating for Tank to play up against Rookie because he's missing so many rockets, and understandably so. Not only does he have Ghost, the moment Rookie pops it, he's just ducking and dodging left and right. He's doing quite well for himself.
I'm just hyped for this replay. I just want that Raz breakdown of how good Rookie was, to be honest.
I've already lost faith.
Yeah, maybe it's not coming. So after Tower went down, plus the Dragon. Pretty important to note in this game. And that will go over to IG. So this time we'll get the consolation prize. Oh! Okay, we're good. We're good. We're safe. Megan was there as well, just waiting for it. And Marge, he's into the top lane. He's on wave clear duty. And again, wave clear, wave clear. That's the name of the game right now as everyone has gone back to base and picked up a fair bunch of items. Oh. Tank jumping after Rookie. SOFM right there. Finished him up. Executed with the ultimate. Meanwhile, a one for one trade. Duke War, fine Tank. And a nice one for one.
Tank definitely didn't need to just go face to face with Rookie, just like right up on him. He probably would have survived, but he's gone so. Throughout the entirety of the game, I don't think he trusts his skill shots that far anymore, especially not up against Rookie. He's dodged so much of his skill shots that he's like, you know what? You can't dodge it if it's literally right in front of you. And that was true. Yeah. You know what? There we go.
He was right. That theory was correct, and that kill did go over to him as well, so he was rewarded for his troubles. Megan and Marge finishing off this top tower. And meanwhile, the bottom lane, Mint and SOFM taking their own. So a tower trade across map, and Kid.
It's not going to stop. Oh, just kidding. As I say that, they're only backing away because, of course, the back is coming through in the bottom side of the map.
Yeah.
Rookie's waiting for the wave, but that's all he's going to get.
Did see that one happening. And SOFM taking a quick look at the Krux before he heads back. Nothing for him on the top side. It was completely cleared out by IG. And he knows he can't get to Herald in time either. That has been star stuff.
I haven't seen so many Rift Herald starts in so long. Usually, primarily, it's just something you don't want to deal with, but this time around, they do have a split pusher in Duke. They are going to prioritize it for him, so I like that fact. Here we go.
Oh, accidental sidestep from Tank. Unleashed power, but he can't sidestep that one. Stranglethorns comes up, knocks Mo into the air. SOFM coming in, but he was exhausted. Still the kill onto Megan. A one for two so far for IG. Nice knock up there from the Kid as well. Another kill onto SM. And this has turned into a bloodbath. The only one remaining is Flandre. He'll try to finish off Marge, but the Warlords will keep him alive. An ace coming in for IG at 2 for 5.
And a triple kill for Rookie. He played that so well. I keep talking about him, but it just, he understood where he burned his ghost, he burned his flash, and he skidded around the fight. Why? Because Flandre, he was a major tank, and he didn't focus down on Syndra as he should have. He was in the left side of the fight. Meanwhile, you know what he did? You know what Rookie did? He just moved around the right. He said, I see where the or at least the back line is. I'm just gonna go straight to Mint, and let's check it out. I mean, it really was, it was as simple as that. Tank had to take the 1v1, not gonna happen. It was a great ulti from Megan overall, but just take a look at where Mo and Mint is, and Rookie just goes straight for them, because Flandre is nowhere near them, and he has so much HP, he doesn't get to use it.
Completely exposed the flank of the team, and Flandre had to feel if his positioning was a little bit different there. The results of that team fight would have been vastly different, but Snake really falling by the wayside, and this could very much go to a game three. IG, that was a very big win for them. And in terms of how much control they have over the map, in terms of the four towers they have over Snake plus that dragon, like, IG are in a perfect situation, and maybe this flank can go even better for them. They'll catch off someone. It's going to be Mo. Oh, nailed with the arrow. Kid, who's thinking about adding insult to injury as he found the ADC, but maybe Mo even getting away from this one. Up.
Mint's not going nowhere,
nope.
Though.
Good luck, mate. Duke coming in from behind, closing that trap around him. That'll be the kill onto the ADC. So the old switcheroo, thought the support was going to go down. It was the ADC. And again, IG keeping up that momentum.
But as at the very least, Snake are saying, you know what, we're going to continue to trade. SOFM does zone Rookie away from the wave, or at least from the tower specifically. So, you know, Tank able to get that mid lane tower, and maybe they can look to threaten this bot lane as well.
That's what we can hope. Flandre pushing this one out, and he'll take a trip back to his spawn pad. Meanwhile, Kid Let's see if he saw him. I don't think he did on the recall, otherwise would have interrupted it. Clearing out the mid wave now, Morell and Armacon, and the makings of a potential Ludens. We'll see if that is what that will go into for Rocky there. The opposite side, Triforce complete from Tank, big spike and damage from him. Waiting on the second item as well from Mint. So approaching item break points, I should say, across the board.
This may seem like a pretty decisive game so far with a 4K lead in IG's behalf, but I really do think that Snake, I mean, they can adapt. They have before, and they recognize that, you know, who's the damage dealer this fight? It's Rookie. So if they can get onto Rookie, if Flandre can focus onto locking down that one powerhouse, then they can actually turn these fights in their favor. Right now, Duke should be looking to split push. That's actually one of his weaknesses, especially since he is a Hydra Trundle. He's not that tanky. That's the problem with him. Even if he starts to steal resistances with his ulti, it's not going to be that big of a deal. He actually can't get shredded through quite easily. So he should be looking to continue the split push pressure coming through. If he joins these team fights, they might have a problem.
So FM, big shield in from his support. Rocky chase after. Lots of missiles, lots of poke damage. And he will manage to get away just in time.
He gets away too easily.
He does. He is an escape artist in this series.
David Blaine himself.
Yeah, turning up. 4-2-1. I guess two times he did not escape. But
yeah.
For the most part, there's been a good amount of times in this game, even alone, that he's gone out of dodge in places he really should not have. SOFM. It seems like a lot of unfortunate situations for him. He has still facilitated his team and gotten a lot of his laners rolling, but often at the cost of his own life.
Yeah, and he's going straight into the tank right now. He has a lot of damage to his name, so that's the problem right now, where he is, as you say, he's going to bat. He's trying to get the assassination. He's barely behind. So right now he's,
looking for another one, but that was just a small combo from Rocky, and had his ultimate been up, that would have been a kill as well. Just a couple seconds left before it comes off cooldown.
I wonder where he's going into with his Negatron. I feel like he's probably going to end up going into GA. Mm. Or even Banshees. Actually, if he can just go straight into Banshees, that might be something he's going into. Oh!
Flandre right onto Marge. Locked down. Can't go anywhere. Easy kill for Tank in the mid lane.
Okay, that's something Marge has been doing a little bit too frequently. Topside, nothing happened. But he was pushing a wave a little bit too far out. And so this is the second time that he's been over-pushing, and this time he actually got punished. So he needs to actually watch himself, especially if he's nowhere near his support or the rest of his team, to just catch what he's been doing, because, you know, you just need to wait for... I'm just repeating myself at this point. Wait for your team.
Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Yeah.
That's the TLDR here.
There we go.
All right, we nailed it. Teamwork.
Wait a minute.
Sat over that ward. They know that they're being revealed. Snake heading away from this Baron. They were thinking about an opportunity. Mo is going to do the same, take away this ward here. Ash is still running in from base. Marge has only just respawned. And everyone backs away. I'm going to have a brief reprise from that one.
Yeah, you're going to have to take a second. It feels like both teams have a lot to learn, especially going into the next skirmish, next fight. Because both teams, honestly, quite even. A lot of consistent damage coming out of Snake right now with Corki and Varus. And honestly, I guess SOFM. Yeah, he's quite consistent. He's going straight into damage. He does build that Banshee's Veil, which is hilarious. and so IG right now, it's a lot harder of a team fight for them, especially since they have to commit to these picks. They don't really have a strong front line at all. I mean, Kid's trying, but he's the only one. And so, if they can get the picks, that's fantastic. But otherwise, if they get caught in these team fights, especially since Flandre is so massive, they can definitely get caught out.
It's going to be the fight over the red buff. If we've learned anything so far, it's fights happen over completely random objectives. But Rookie will put a stop to that and just take that one away.
This time around, IG does have a lot of pressure over Baron. 24 minutes into the game. They technically can't do it because they don't have a front line to really deal with it. If Kid's the only one actually tanking out that Baron, he's going to lose a lot of HP. So they don't have the ability to peel back off of it, especially with no Ocean Dragons or Honey Fruits to honestly save them out. So Snake, they have a little bit of a comfort zone where they can actually start up because Maokai's just that big right now. And maybe even, but we'll see. They can definitely stall out. That's the problem with this right now. They can stall it out a little longer.
Marge picking up red buff as well at this point in the game. Taking a look at the item breakpoints once more. Triforce and rapid fire cannon as well for Tank. He's got the package even. and the Hex Drinker, so he's in pretty good shape to ruin someone's day in the near future. Taking away the crab as well for IG and Snake. Heading up river, see if they can find anyone by the lonesome, perhaps find a straggler. Not quite right now, and again, the spit push continues from Duke.
The two differences, or at least the one difference I see here from between Megan and Mo, is the fact that Megan, of course, right now is going towards his Liandry's Torment, which is going to be a big deal. Once he does actually end up getting it, he's going to be doing quite a lot of damage towards Liandry, and that's going to be a big deal. And being able to shred out that one major threat, if he can do that, that's fantastic. And that's what they're going to be waiting for, but Duke, waiting for nothing.
Well, we know he's not that tanky, but with the subjugate, stealing some health, stealing some resistances by Liandry, he'll get up. Wait, did he get that? Okay, no, I can't tell, because Tank has a buff.
Yeah, I think Corki has it, but he probably already had it. Mm.
We'll have to find out. Well, Rookie's got another move up, so I'm going to assume that Duke did not get it.
Yeah.
So he was trying. He was trying his heart out.
But overall, yeah, it just goes back to the point that Redemption has been built on Mo. Mm. So the team fight, they already have a strong team fight, and a Redemption on top of a Maokai is pretty disgusting. Ooh. You know, SOFM didn't even feel the breeze on that one.
That was not even close. Unfortunately, IG were sat on the ward, so easy for SOFM to see that one coming from a mile away. It's just a game of someone waiting to be picked out, someone waiting to get caught, a pick opening up for one of these two teams.
And this is what sucks for IG. Right now, the only thing they can do is look for that pick. They can kill Vision as much as they can and look for these picks, and here we go.
Well, they found it regardless onto SOFM. Nice little rotation there with the gank squad from Marge, Megan, and Rookie. A kill onto the jungler is pretty damn perfect.
Yeah, they're going to go for the Baron now. So this shouldn't have happened. SOFM should have recognized that they had so much vision that he is not a tank. Him tanking that out doesn't really mean anything. So right now, what can Snake do? I don't think they can do anything about this.
It's down to half.
Oh.
Rookie wants damage from range, but be careful. Mint throwing out Chains of Corruption. Going to spread onto Marge and Rookie. Oh. It's dropping very low. This could be down to the wire. Liandry in the pit. This could be finished off by Snake, but they're going to continue on to this fight here. Liandry onto Duke, trying to melt the Trundle. Get a lot of health back from that subjugate. And after all of that, and everyone backs away, I feel like maybe someone could have finished off that Baron. It was so close.
It's really hard because if, honestly, if Snake had turned on it, Mint was actually taking a lot of damage from Baron because they started to push forward. And they were having that decision. Do we want to go on Baron? It's fairly low. Do we want to push on the team fight? If they went for Baron, not only would they have gotten demolished by the fact that Baron was still existing, and they would, you know, IG would have turned on them. So it was a very difficult situation. They both had to part ways, especially since IG, sure, they may have killed the jungler, but they definitely could not deal with the Maokai at all. And they were taking far too much damage. Which comes back to the initial worry. They just don't have a true tank. The only one right here is in Kit, and he's not reliable enough here.
Very true. I know I would have gone for it, but that's why I'm boosted and why these guys are playing, of course, on the LPL stage. So, wait for this, wait for the reset, wait for another team to go for the objective. Just like this one, here's the Infernal Dragon, SOFM, and Liandry starting it off. But the trap has been set up from IG. Arrow lands onto Mo. Will be the collapser as well. Kid coming over the wall and locked down. Mo still somehow alive. Now he's got the help of the blast plant there. SOFM finishing off the dragon. So many low members. Everyone flashing up red, but it's Kid, the first one to fall. Duke taking a lot of damage from tank. He'll get out of dodge, and that'll just be the one kill for the with the dragon as well. So nice win for Snake.
This is a big problem for IG right now. They're starting to feel it that they're not actually committing to split pushing, so they're realizing that they can't team fight. Tank just zoned out four people. In what world does that happen? A world where he does a lot of burst damage, and no one can walk up to him. Not a single person. Even Duke had a problem with it. So the moment Kid was in there, there was no way coming out. There was no damage to follow up on, and for a good reason. So right now, they have to double check what they're doing. I mean, I guess they have no choice to deal with this Baron.
No, caught in the Strangle Thorns. Some damage incoming from the Grasping Roots. Rookie will be there to finish off the Force of Will. Meanwhile, Arrow coming down from Marge. SOFM deleted. Duke hammering away at Mint, and now onto Liandry. The Baron is very low, down to 1,000 HP. It's going to be Kid with the smite secure. Liandry also down. 3-0 to IG, plus the Baron. Massive power play.
That's insane. It's not going to stop here.
Tank
is done.
Tank, he was trying. Oh! Whoa! That does a 1-for-1, nukes him down for the kill. I thought he was screwed up. He was looking for the frame-perfect cleanse.
Yeah, but regardless of that, even though that amazing trade went through, IG just stole Baron, or at least they took it. They stole it from the fight. They got the fight. They got the Baron, and now they're taking the inhib.
They're taking a lot from this. Opening up the base now from Snake. Flandrake Tank and SOFM still down, so Kid will help the team take the top tower on top of that.
That was just a bad start on Baron. That's what it comes down to. That they can take the fight, but they didn't really. They were so confident in the fact that they're just going to go all in on Baron that they just got picked out. 100% SOFM just does not have HP. Even sure, you have Banshee'sville. What does that mean? What does that mean in the grand scheme of things? Rookie can just pop that with a Q, and then he has ulti. Like that, or at least the stun and the follow-up. So it just comes down to you're just not tanking enough, and the only one is. I mean, he's just looking at the rest of his team dying. Especially since, here's the thing with Mo got picked off. That's fair, right? It's, at that point, you're like, all right, well, you know, that's bad.
Yeah.
But then he used Redemption for nothing. Absolutely nothing. And you can use Redemption while you're dead. Why was he being selfish with it? He could just allow himself to die. That's going to happen. Maybe he can live a second longer, but there was no way that was going to happen. There's a Syndra running at you. So you're dead. But you can actually still contribute to the fight by using Redemption for the rest of your team. And that's something that he built into.
For sure. So just a bit of an oversight there coming in from the support. But it's SOFM I'm looking towards right now. He was attempting a gank in the top lane onto Duke, but he is playing quite far back. Hard to make that one happen. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, there is three-man pressure from IG. And they can just play this game. Two people in those single lanes. Make sure mid is pushing it. Help that one come along with those super minions. Now rotate the fourth member into the bottom lane with this minion wave pushing.
It's definitely a lot easier to split push with these Baron pressure, and Trundle's doing a lot right now here. Just wiping at it. It doesn't really matter to him. He doesn't care.
Flandre having a horrible time. Pretty much nothing he can do as a lonely Maokai. Probably not the person that they wanted to deal with that Trundle in that situation, and that has opened up yet another inhib. Tank instantly deleted. Nice play there from Rookie. I mean, it was even overkill of Marge's ultimate thrown on top. And with that kill, it's going to be bottom tower falling, top tower also under attack. It's actually all of Snake collapsing on Duke, but look at him. He's 1 versus 4, and he's not even dying. He's good to go. Oh. He's out. And Min dropping so low just from that damage in from Rookie. Mo and Min kiting to the left and to the right, but they're both going to fall. And it's Flandre, the only member remaining, but not for long. Flattened by Syndra. And SOFM is going to pad his CS core lines by the end of the game, but it's IG the ones to take this one. Yeah, what a stark contrast, Raz.
That has to be game. That was ridiculous. They're just pushing SOFM. But as you said, that was quick.
Marge flash? Nope. Okay, so it's going to be SOFM getting away with his life. He's out of range of the volley. And that's game two over to IG, evening up the tables. We're going to game three.
They should have done that a long time ago. IG specifically should have started their split push pressure. Them playing towards the team fight was not a very smart decision, but they did it nonetheless. They finally got a random Baron. That saved them. Yep. And then after that, you know what? It made it that easier to just start to split push with Trundle.
And once again, welcome back my good friend Froskuren. How are you doing?
Pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Kind of thoughts on that game?
The same problems for IG are still existing. As a five-man unit, they're not working, but again, they have such great potential on the roster that they're able to dig it back. Yes,